Hi, welcome to Working Man Studios. My name's Carl. Today we're going to be talking about the MXL 3000. Many of you have asked for a review demo of this because there's not that many of them on YouTube. So I'm happy to help you out. First of all, let me say that I'm sorry for not posting videos. I am, as you can see, at college, and it's very difficult for me to post videos between practices for school sports and just general homework, so I'm sorry about that, but I'm going to do what I can. Let's start off. MXL 3000 is a 900 series that's made by MXL, obviously. It's probably their best quality microphone in the 900 series. As you can see, it's a large diaphragm. Let's see if I can get that in the light here. You can kind of see it. It's a large diaphragm condenser microphone. And what that means is it's got a very large pickup, basically. And it's able to pick up more sound and have more sensitivity than your average small diaphragm condenser microphone. It's a cardioid pattern microphone, as you can see indicated by the symbol right there. It's a cardioid pattern, so it picks up in a heart shape in the front and rejects from the rear. This microphone has a 30 to 20 hertz response, so you have the lowest frequency is 30, highest frequency is 20. That's pretty good. It gets very low enough to record bass and high enough to record any kind of instrument that gets real high, piano, violin, stuff like that. So it works good for a multitude of instruments. It sells for $180 on Musician's Friend, and it does come with like a bundle which includes like a pop screen and whatnot. I'd recommend getting the bundle if you could. I'll tell you what I got here. I have just the mic, and the mic also comes with, excuse me, I might put this down. The mic comes in this silver case. It's pretty good. It's made out of aluminum. Not the strongest of the metals, but it'll do the job. Inside the case, it's got nice foam padding. Sorry, I can't get that on camera. Nice foam padding, and it's got, you know, a place for the mic, clip, and a windscreen. The clip is just a standard MXL clip. The ones that you see come with the MXL 990 and stuff like that. And the windscreen isn't the thickest, but it does a pretty good job of blocking the plosives and the S sounds. The mic itself, there's been some rumors about this going around that it has actually basically just the M3. If you know the MXL M3, it's a silicon valve microphone. And we can actually open this up. I'll open it up for you. We can take a look inside, and it looks to be like there is a silicon valve in this microphone, which it's still a rumor, but you'll see in a second that if I take this apart, this here, I'm not sure if this is a silicon valve because I'm not an expert on the components of the electronics, but I have opened up my MXL V6, which is a silicon valve microphone, and it does have this box right here. And I've opened up some other non-tube solid FET microphones, and they don't have this. So whatever this is, maybe someone can post what this is in the description box. That'd be helpful. It shows up in their higher quality microphones. So just an indication, this may be just a rebranding of one of their more expensive microphones. Obviously with that you would get lesser quality components, but the sound of this microphone is great, as you will hear when I start the demo up here. So that was just a little bit of a background of the MXL and the accessories that you get with it. I'm going to hook this up to my system here. Now, mind you, my system is not as good as the one that I have back home. I'm using a tube preamp. I think I'll send this through straight dry, and I won't add any effects or anything. No processing will go through here. It's going through a UCA 222 interface. Not the best interface, but it's what I use for college. If you're going to get this microphone here, is what it looks like. It's a blue silver finish. If you're going to get this microphone in here, I do recommend getting a shock mount. Something to hold the microphone in, because that clip right there, if you're moving around the table or something, you hit the mic stand, it causes a lot of unnecessary low rumble. So if you want to get, if you want to make good quality recordings, I urge you to get this MXL shock mount. It's a great quality shock mount.
Hi, welcome back. We've got the MXL 3000 here all hooked up, running into the board and whatnot. It's going straight into the board, no tube preamp or anything. I do not have the low cut filter on. If you listen closely, other than the computer noise, I do hear a low rumble. So I'm going to switch the low cut filter on just so you can see how it sounds. And magically like that, the low cut filter works. I don't hear any more low rumble. Sounds like I cut a little bit of lows out of my voice, but I do not hear any low rumble anymore. For the purposes of this demo, I'm just going to leave it off. It's got relatively good gain, just the board itself doesn't have the greatest gain. Again, I'm sorry for the computer noise if that's disturbing you. You can hear I'm about 7 inches away from the mic. You can get up on this microphone, and I'm trying to talk softly because I don't want to clip it, because I'm not monitoring my input right now. But it has a very silky smooth sound. It does sound pretty good for a low cost microphone. And I can move back, and it still sounds really good. There's a little bit of room noise. Sorry for the phone. There's a little bit of room noise, but there's not a whole lot of room noise, so it's very usable. If you just get up a little bit closer to it, I think within the 3-inch distance is probably the best place for this microphone. It really just does sound good at about 3 inches. Not saying you can't use it a little back, not saying you can't get right up on it. I'm saying merely 3 inches with a small pop screen is probably your best bet on this microphone. On the frequency range, I hear a good blend of the whole range. I'm going to put a picture up right now, and you can see that if you're looking at the screen here, the frequency range is extremely flat, except for about in the high end when you get to about 8,000 kilohertz, because they added a big boost basically to add detail to the microphone. But for a budget microphone and what you're going to be using it for, this is a very excellent quality microphone. I'm very happy I purchased it, and I do use it quite often for Skyping, podcasting, and also recording vocals and guitar. All right, I hope you have enjoyed this review. If you need any help with this, I am planning on starting a Working Man Studios Skype chat. So if you need some help, you just contact me on Working Man Studios, and I can Skype with you, and you can get your problems solved that way. So if you think that's a good idea, please message me and tell me, hey, go through with that idea. And I hope you enjoy this microphone if you buy it, and thanks for watching.